if Trump can turn this election in the courts, he'll have, or in the state legislatures, in those affected states, I think there's 5 or 7 of them, have the power to throw out the election results, which are fraudulent, and send a slate of electors to the Electoral College that will vote for Trump. He will win.
I see voter fraud happening in Georgia, in Wisconsin, in Michigan, and in the states that were the battle states. They are proving that Trump did win.
I'm very disturbed at what I see in the manipulations in the elections in all of the battleground states, in particular the use of the Dominion voting machines with the software in it, that I'm seeing Sidney Powell now come out and say that they have evidence of how the votes, up to 3% of the votes, were flipped in the computer.
Most of them were for Biden only, nothing else. And then they found a lot of votes from dead people and just illegal votes, and they need to recount. That's the whole thing.
I can hardly believe that a person who couldn't draw a dozen people to a rally all of a sudden gets more votes than any presidential candidate in history.
Yeah, and to me the biggest, well, maybe the second biggest problem after that is the biased media. For 4 years, they've been pretty much relentless in terms of going after Trump, attacking Trump. It seems like objectivity when it comes to journalism, or just objectivity in general, is sort of going out the window.
Well, it has since the day he was elected, since the hour of his election, and even before that. And it's a sad thing in America that we have this situation with a dishonest media.
The media has to be fixed. All of the social media, all of the controlled media has to be fixed. It's treasonous what they're doing.
How do you feel about the way that Trump supporters are portrayed in the media? You're automatically a racist, you're automatically a bigot.
That's why I'm here. I want you to see my face. I want you to hear my message of love. We're not here because we hate somebody. We're here because we appreciate and we're grateful for what this man has done for us in our country.
How do you feel about the way that a lot of Trump supporters are portrayed in America? You're automatically a racist, you're automatically a bigot, you're automatically a hillbilly. It's sort of the same people that are telling you that you should be tolerant and accept other people, they sort of forget their own message when it comes to people they don't like.
Well, a lot of these people are young, and I feel like as an adult and not a child, that name-calling is ineffective. And that's all it is name calling. And they should just, like, go back to school.
This is the most unracist country in the nation. Look at the, who did we elect as president and re-elect him? Barack Obama. What color was he? What color was Eric Holder? What color is Clarence Thomas? What color is, I could go on down the list of many, many, many prominent people in leadership in this country are black. We elect them and we expect them to do a good job just like we expect anybody else does. So this is a total bogus smear campaign to call Trump supporters racist. We are anything but that.
We're protesting, but this is a peaceful protest.
No rioting, no looting?
Hell no.
We're not burning buildings. We're not starting fights. We're here doing what Americans have the right to do. And back our president, back the right for free and peaceful protests. And that's being a good American, right here.
I'm second generation American. My grandmother told me, you gotta stand up and fight. I said, Grandma, you can't fight City Hall. She says, of course you can. You might not win, but you gotta fight.
We're gonna win this thing. There's just no way. This isn't 8 years ago. This isn't 8 years ago. We didn't win by a little margin, and then there's enough chicanery in all the states that they control that we can say, no, he won it. And the fake candidate's like, all right, I'm good. No. Trump won in a landslide. He won 10 million more votes than last time. Obama won fewer counties than, I'm sorry, Biden won fewer counties than Obama in 2012. Do you really think that there wasn't something going on? The Democrats historically, whether it's Tammany Hall or the 1960 election in Texas with LBJ running the thing, or Kennedy and Sam Gianni in Chicago, they're known for doing this. It's not a trick. No one's going to say, any honest historian or any honest person who knows American politics knows that this happens. The question is, how much? Enough to steal a presidential election? But what we're saying is, yeah, Oh, yeah.
If Biden gets in, we will keep on fighting for our republic and our freedoms and our Constitution.
And we're fighting for the man who's standing up for us.
He's not even taking a paycheck, people. Not even a paycheck. Okay? But they don't think he's done anything because they're watching the mainstream media. They don't go on his site or the White House site and look at everything he's accomplished, which, yes, he had to do a lot of executive orders because they couldn't get anything through the House. Okay? Pay attention, America.
Legal votes have to be counted, and illegal votes have to be thrown out because that spits in the face of our nation. And of every other election that has happened in this nation. And I'm so grateful that President Trump is not lying down and taking it. So God bless President Trump. God bless every man, woman, and child who is standing up and not going to take this anymore.
I just hope he wins. That's all I got to say. I hope he makes a recovery, and I hope America finds out this man is doing a lot for this country.
Yeah, let's say if he isn't reelected, what do you see for America for the next 4 years?
I don't even want to say. It's not good, y'all. We're already partly owned by other countries. I truly believe. I don't even want to say.
I know that President Trump won this election. And I'm not going to say otherwise.